Hi there, welcome to the demonstration of our product vCAN Canvas Analyzer. This product comes in two parts, the hardware and the associated application software. The hardware looks like this. It is a compact plastic casing with USB cable on one end and a 9-pin D-type cable on the other end. It also has two LEDs, one LED to indicate the activity on the CAN bus and the other LED to indicate the activity on the USB bus. On the software part, you need to have the drivers for this hardware pre-installed on your computer before starting to use this product. In my case, since I already have the drivers for this hardware already installed on my computer, as I open the device manager, you can see when I plug the hardware to the USB port, you can see the device is automatically recognized and listed by Windows under the Universal Serial Bus Devices in Device Manager. The application software is a separate utility which you need to install through its own installer. If it is successfully installed, you will have a shortcut created for this application on your desktop. This shortcut looks like this. Both the application software and the hardware USB drivers are freely downloadable from our website. Now, since I have plugged the hardware and it is recognized by Windows, let me invoke the application. So the application looks like this. Since the hardware drivers are already installed and I have plugged the hardware, you can notice the application has opened without reporting any hardware related error. Before starting to demonstrate the features of the vCAN application, I need a source of CAN messages at the hardware level, that is a test hardware which can generate the CAN messages which can be analyzed through the CAN bus analyzer. For this, I am using our other product, vCAN Unimod. vCAN Unimod is a universal CAN module which can be configured to generate CAN messages at the hardware level. It can also accept incoming CAN messages and output the contents of that particular CAN message on its output LEDs. So this is where the output LEDs are there. So I'm using one such universal CAN module, vCAN Unimod, to demonstrate the CAN bus analyzer features. So you can see the CAN bus pins, CAN high and CAN low pins of the CAN bus analyzer have been connected to the corresponding CAN pins of my test hardware. So let me power up the hardware. So I have powered up the hardware. Now going to the application. So since I have configured the test hardware to work at a CAN baud rate of 500 kbps, I will go to the config tab and select same baud rate of 500 kbps in the CAN bus analyzer. So go to the monitor window and start the application. So you can see as I start the application, the CAN bus analyzer receives the CAN messages generated by the test hardware and starts showing them on the monitor window. The first column represents the type of message. So in my case, these are all received messages. You can see the content of that message in the fourth byte D4 is hexadecimal FF. As I turn the potentiometer on my test hardware, you can see the content D4 changing in value. So I'm going to the towards the minimum. So it is 0, 0. So this is how I turned the potentiometer on my test hardware. So I'm leaving it in somewhere in the middle position, and if I see it in the application, the value is here. So this is about the receiving part. The CAN bus analyzer can also be used to transmit messages onto the CAN bus. For that, we need to use the message creator tab. So let me temporarily stop the application. So my test hardware has been configured to receive incoming CAN message with message ID 1CD. So let me create a message ID with ID 1CD with data in the fourth byte being let us say 0F hexadecimal, and this has to be transmitted when I press key F1 on my computer. So let me add this to the list. So let me create another instance of the same message, that is with the same message ID 1CD, with the data now being F0, and it has to be transmitted when I press F2. So let me add this instance to the list. So a third instance, when I press F3 with a different data, let us say with hexadecimal CC, has to be transmitted. So I will create and add this to the list. So I am ready with three instances of a particular CAN message with different datas on pressing different keys. So let me go back to the monitor window. So if I start the application, you can see the messages are only being received as of now. So as I press key F1 on my computer, you can see a transmitted message identified as TX in the first column. Its content is 0F in the fourth byte. When I press F2, you can see the different instance with data F0 in the fourth byte. If I press F3, you can see the third instance with the data CC. So this is how CAN messages can be transmitted. So let me show you what is happening on the hardware as I press the keys. You can see the blue LEDs changing. So because the test hardware is configured to receive these CAN messages and output the content onto the LEDs. So you can see again, as I press different keys, the data in the fourth byte changes and it is reflected in the output LEDs on my test hardware. So this is about the transmitting and receiving features of our vCAN Canvas Analyzer. So there are many more features. Like if you go to the config tab, you can see various operating modes. You can see even the support for custom baud rate. You can log the contents as it appears on the monitor window into a log file. Similarly, if you go to the message creator, instead of transmitting the messages on pressing a key, you can transmit the messages periodically with this option, 500 millisecond up to 10 seconds. And there is even an option to generate transmit a CAN message in response to a received CAN message. So these are the various features. So this is about our product. For more information about our product and also various other products, please visit our website tangenttechnolabs.com. You can mail to us at contact@tangenttechnolabs.com for any further details or queries. Thanks for watching this video. We'll hope it will be useful for you, and we'll come back with more videos. Take care. Bye bye.